兄弟姐妹，我们又在一起来聚会敬拜神了。
Hallelujah, dearest brothers and sisters, once again we gather together to worship God.
哎呀，反正就在能够有机会跟大家一起敬拜神，来勉励道理，真的是心里很高兴。
And in fact, I definitely feel very joyful, especially when we have the time to worship God together.
好，我们大家用一颗虔诚敬拜神的心来开始，同心默祷。
With a God-fearing heart, we begin with a silent prayer.
Amen. 奉主耶稣圣名，开始我们两处教会的晚间聚会。
In the name of the Lord Jesus, we begin our evening service between two churches.
我们唱赞美诗236首。
We sing him 236.
我属耶稣。
Jesus is mine.
今天唱这首诗歌，是因为我们会看到一个生命的改变。
Today we sing this hymn to prepare ourselves to see a change in life.
它本来是要被神审判的。
This is a life that was meant to be judged by God.
但是很奇妙，到后来它却属于耶稣，成为耶稣的人。
And miraculously, this life became one which belonged to Jesus.
所以这首诗说，这是非常奇妙的事。
And therefore, this hymn tells us this is such a blessed assurance.
一、二、三，知道的父亲，我属耶稣，救主已赎回我出我罪苦，得主宝贝血洗净罪污。圣灵敬礼幸福阿爸父喜气的心系我属耶稣赞美我救主歌唱欢呼诉说主慈爱珍珠恩典感谢主救赎我属耶稣完全顺服主万事安宁天堂的灯永耀使我看清仿佛有天使颂赞歌声大民族救恩民族传用喜气的信息我是耶稣赞美我救主歌唱欢呼诉说主慈爱珍珠恩典感谢主救赎我是耶稣万事感谢主奉献赞诗永远的真生命是我无语诗歌仰望主尽心一杯无助的祈祷更出来时喜气的信息我属耶稣赞美我救主歌唱欢呼诉说主慈爱珍珠恩典感谢主救赎我们一起祷告，求主祝福带领我们。
Let's also say a prayer to ask the Lord Jesus for His guidance.
哈利路亚，奉主耶稣圣名祷告。哈利路亚，感谢赞美主耶稣。哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚
Hallelujah, 奉主耶稣圣灵正道。
Hallelujah, in the name of Lord Jesus, I speak.
主所亲爱的大家晚上平安啊。
Dearest my sisters, whom the Lord Jesus loves, peace be with you.
感谢主，我们今天继续使徒行传第九章。
We thank the Lord Jesus, we'll continue on Acts of the Apostles, chapter 9 today.
我们继续看到教会在风雨中前进。We
continue to see how the church forages forward in the storm.
而且呢，神行了一个很大的奇迹。
And also the great miracle that is performed by God.
就是一个很恨耶稣的人，很讨厌耶稣的人，逼迫耶稣的人，杀害信徒的人，改变来信主。
And that is when someone who hated the Lord Jesus persecuted his people, and finally he transformed to be a believer of Jesus Christ.
这是我们看到突破很大的风雨，很大的风暴，把它突破。
Yes, indeed, a major breakthrough through the storm.
讲起来这是圣灵的工作了。And
you can say that it is the work of the Holy Spirit.
有哪一个人可以改变一个人呢？
How can anyone have the ability to change the other person?
我们自己有时都不能够改变自己，我们很想改变自己，有时都没办法改变自己。
And sometimes we want to change ourselves, but we are not able to even change ourselves.
好，我们看《使徒行传》第九章，请读第九章。
Read Acts of the Apostles, chapter 9.
一个传奇人物的出现。
The emergence of a legendary figure.
那智慧帮忙念一节到第九节，先念到第九节先。
好, we read from verses 1 to 9. In the name of Jesus, I read. Then Saul, still breathing threats and murder against the disciples of the Lord, went to the high priest, verse 2, and asked the letters from him to the synagogues of Damascus, so that if he found any who were of the way, whether men or women, he might bring them bound to Jerusalem. Verse 3, as he journeyed, he came near Damascus, and suddenly a light shone around him from heaven. Verse 4, then he fell to the ground and heard a voice saying to him, Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? Verse 5, and he said, who are you, Lord? Then the Lord said, I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting. It is hard for you to kick against the goats. Verse 6, so he, trembling and astonished, said, Lord, what do you want me to do? Then the Lord said to him, arise and go to the city, and you will be told what you must do. Verse 7, and the man who journeyed with him stood speechless, hearing a voice but seeing no one. Verse 8, then Saul arose from the ground, and when his eyes were opened, he saw no one. But they led him by the hand and brought him into Damascus. Verse 9, and he was 3 days without sight, and neither ate nor drank.
我们暂时先读到这里先。
We'll stop here.
那从他的出现到他的改变。
From his emergence to his transformation,
一直到他的死,
until his death,
都是一个传奇,
it all tells a legend.
那从13章开始到最后的28章, 全部都是记录保罗的事迹, 保罗传福音的事迹。
From chapters 13 to 28, it all records of the incidences related to Paul.
那么从13章开始, 我们看到他
And we can see from chapter 13 that Paul that dedicated his whole life to testify for the truth. Until the very end, he also martyred for the gospel.
那他的出现呢,就是在使徒行传第七章,还记得吗?
Do you remember that he first appeared in this Acts of the Apostles in chapter 7?
那59节到60节,这里介绍我们,那时候他的出现不过是一个少年人。
It first introduced him in chapter 7, verse 59 to 60, as Saul was only in his youth.
那么我们看到他在少年时期,就为立法这么的热心,这么样的参与了。
As we can see, this younger Saul, who was already very zealous for the word of God, for the scriptures and the law.
那从这里我们可以看出，他对信仰哦，对律法是非常热心、非常虔诚的。
And we can see that he was very fervent and full of zeal towards the law of God.
而是说，今天的少年人哦，不是青年哦，少年哦，哪有人去理教会啊？理什么信仰啊？啊，什么神的律法？谁理这些东西呀？
And you be honest to yourself, look at our youth today. Who among us are so fervent and zealous about matters regarding our faith?
偶尔有来聚会都已经很了不起了，你来聚会要讲到半死，要骂到半死才不敢愿来哦。
We would already applaud them if they're able to come to church for services, otherwise we'll have to scold them and drag them to church.
但是扫罗的出现呢，是从他少年后开始就看到他的行为，少年的时候。
And the appearance of Saul when he was young, he was a youth.
那一直到九章一节呢，我们就看到他的改变了，神拣选他，主要是拣选他而改变。
But as we come to chapter 9, verse 1, we can see his transformation from the as God elected him.
他蒙主耶稣的恩惠啊，蒙主耶稣拣选，他本来应该哦是要被主耶稣审判而死的。
By the grace and choosing of the Lord Jesus, he who was supposed to be condemned to judgment.
不单止主耶稣没有审判他，还将荣耀的使命托付给他。
Not only was he freed from this condemnation of his judgment, he was also being entrusted with a great mission of the gospel.
不单只给他荣耀的使命，还给他荣耀的职分啊，成为使徒啊。
Not only was he given the glorious mission, he was also being given the glorious title as the apostle.
老实说，这样的一个人哦，真的是应该本来就是应该要被审判的，被主耶稣审判的。
And in all reason, someone like him should have been condemned to the greatest judgment of God. And now we can see that the love and the works of God are indeed very different from the ways of men.
那他确实是一个从黑暗进入光明的人。
He was indeed someone who walked out of darkness into light.
他真的是一位从撒旦议会，从撒旦帮的人，改变成为神家里面的人。
He was indeed someone who was part of the ministry of this of Satan, who was transformed into part of the ministry and the household of God.
所以在信仰上大家要注意哦，在信仰上。
Therefore, in our matters of faith, we have to take note.
撒旦帮的人，撒旦议会的人，可以改变成为神家里的人，可以。
In the ministry, someone from the ministry of Satan could be changed into become a part of the household of God.
那同样的，在神家里面的人，也可以改变成为撒旦帮的人，撒旦议会的人。
In similar fashion, someone who is from the household of God could be transformed and changed into to become a part of the ministry of Satan.
这件事情我们从圣经上可以看到，也可以从我们教会的历史到今天看得到。And
this is something that we can already witness from today's context as well as from the history of our church.
对，大家要谨慎自己哦。Therefore,
you all ought to be vigilant.
哦，撒旦的人可以成为神家的人，神家的人也可以成为撒旦的人。
People of Satan can become the part of the household of God, and people of the household of God can also become part of Satan.
那犹大的例子就是这样啊，那个使徒犹大出卖耶稣的，他就是神家里面的人成为撒旦的人啊。There
is also an example that we can see from Judas, who changed from the household of God into the household of Satan.
还有今天最近这几年里面，我们真教会、真耶稣教会化成的传道人的变质，神的工人。 神的工人变成撒旦的工人啊，替撒旦做事，替撒旦哦毁谤教会，哦攻击教会，被称为撒旦的人啊。And
as well as in recent years, we can also witness that there are the workers of God who have corrupted themselves to become the workers of Satan.
嗯，他是从恨耶稣到爱耶稣的一个人。
From someone who hated Jesus, he became someone who loved Jesus.
他是从逼迫耶稣到为耶稣而死的人。From
someone who persecuted Jesus to become someone who martyred for the sake of Jesus.
他是从逼迫教会到建立教会的人。From
persecuting a church, he became someone who built the church.
所以我说，他确实是一位传奇人物，很奇妙的人物。Which
is why I said that he lived up to the expectation to become a legendary man in the Bible.
他确实是完完全全的改变。He
was an all-out, full transformation of himself.
他是彻彻底底的改变。It
was a complete transformation.
他本来是神要审判的人，却成了神重用的工人。He
was supposed to be someone who was condemned to judgment, but yet he was transformed into someone who was utilized, a great vessel utilized by God.
这件事情应验了罗马书第五章所说的道理。And
this indeed has also testified what is mentioned in Romans chapter 5.
也是保罗他自己讲的，自己做的见证。
It is also the testimony borne by Paul himself.
我们看罗马书五章六节到八节。We
turn to Romans chapter 5, verse 6 to verse 8.
因为我们还软弱的时候，基督就按所定的日期为罪人死；为义人死是少有的，为忍人死或者有敢做的。第八节。Verse
8.
唯有基督在我们还做罪人的时候为我们死，神的爱就在此向我们显明了。 那这段圣经哦，就是应验在保罗的身上呀。This
passage of the Bible has been lived out in the life of Paul.
神爱他的时候，他就是在抵挡神的时候；神爱他的时候，他就是在逼迫教会的时候。The
time when he was persecuting the church and resisting God, it was also the time when God loved him.
在我们还做罪人的时候，神就这样爱我们，神就这样的拣选我们。
Even as we were sinners, the Lord God has already loved us by choosing us.
Not only for Paul, it was also the same for most of us today. It is by the love of God. Today we want to say that we want to be witnesses and we want to testify for the love of God, and what would you have to do for that? There are many religions across the world who are also preaching about love, about feasting and drinking. What kind of love is that?
那圣经对这位保罗传奇人物的出现，他是怎样的介绍呢？
How did the Bible introduce such a legendary figure such as Paul?
第一，他是由少年人的形象出现。圣经介绍他的时候，是从少年人的形象出现。Firstly,
the Bible introduced Paul as when he was still a youth.
他是参与杀人、看守衣服的少年人。
This is a youth who was also involved in persecuting and also killing.
借助圣经进一步介绍，他是一位喜悦神的仆人被杀的人。神的仆人被杀，他是非常高兴的。And
then the Bible went on to elaborate that he was someone who would be pleased by killing people, the workers of God.
那圣经再进一步的介绍，他是一位残害教会的人。
And the Bible went on to elaborate that he was also someone who persecuted the church with the worst kind of cruelty.
看圣经对他的介绍，从看守衣服到喜欢神的工人被杀，到残害教会、逼迫教会。
And now the Bible has described this person as someone who was in his youth and who was then persecuting the church and also taking the worst kind of treatment against the church.
他逼迫主呢，是从旁观者到参与者。
From in his journey of persecuting Christ, it was from as a bystander to become the persecutor.
从参与者变成带领者，是带领的人，做头的人。
From being part of persecution, from being one of the persecutors, he also became the leader, the chief among the persecutors.
9:1 describes
him as someone who was also the leader of the persecutors.
圣经这样介绍我们，让我们认识，今天逼迫教会的人哦，他是越逼迫越大的，他是越陷越深的，他不会停手的。The
Bible described him and introduced him as someone who continued to grow worse and worse and to become more and more cruel and in his persecution.
他是会越来越凶恶，越来越恨教会的。
He was one who was described as to be more and more ferocious and more hateful against towards the church.
为什么会这样呢？
Why? How was that possible?
让你从开始从旁观者到参与者的时候，或者你心里喜欢教会被逼迫的时候，你喜欢这样做的时候，你只是喜欢哦，你就开始抑制陷下去了，你就开始一直会逼迫教会，一定会越来越凶的。
From simply becoming a bystander of the persecution against Christ, he continues to sink deeper and deeper and becoming more and more ferocious against the church.
注意哦，这种行为不会减少，只是会让你越来越深，越来越恨教会，越来越讨厌教会。Take
note that this kind of behavior would not be reduced. It will only lead you into deeper and deeper hatred against the church.
那圣经用惨害哦。 惨害教会，看8:3，扫罗惨害教会，这个惨害的原文是兽性的残酷，野兽般的残酷。In
chapter 8, verse 3, here it says that Saul made havoc of the church, and in the original text, it carries the meaning of the behavior of a beast wreaking havoc.
好像野兽，他追到那个猎物的时候。 把那个猎物撕咬，然后把它撕碎，把它撕裂，这样的残忍啊，甚至连肠都拉出来。This
is the kind of cruelty that you can see likened to a beast tearing apart the carcasses of other animals and spilling off the intestines from the inside.
圣经这样记录，这样描述是有它意思的。
There is a reason behind why the Bible described him this way.
你看他从一个看守衣服的少年人变成很凶恶、很凶残的野兽，已经成为野兽了，不再是人了。
From someone who was just a keeper or a bystander, he turned himself into a beast-like person, no longer like a human.
人外表上是人啊，但是里面是残暴的豺狼，残暴的野兽。
He was only a man by outward appearance, but deep inside him, he was a raging beast.
特别他这样残暴哦，是对那些善良的人，对那些哦。那些啊，爱那些基督徒，基督徒都很善良的呀，不跟人家都不能跟人家争，不跟人家哦，不做坏事的呀。他的残忍是对善良的人，你知道吗
？And his ferociousness, his cruelty is especially great against those who are meek and humble, like those who are Christians.
如果他的残暴是对那些恶人。恶人对恶人，野兽对了野兽，我没话讲啊。反正大家都是野兽啊，那你们打死他吧，打倒他嘛。你们都是本来这么凶的人啊。
I wouldn't comment a lot if he were to be ferocious against other people like his kind, who are also just as ferocious and as cruel as violent.
但是我们看到这些所谓的野兽哦，这些恶人啊。都是在杀害善良人，欺负善良的人。
And all we can see is that the wicked or the beasts, have always been bullying or hurting those who are kind.
你没有看到这些凶恶的野兽吗？他专吃的、专猎、专杀害的都是羊啊、鹿啊，那些很可爱的动物啊，这些动物都很可怜啊，在他们的面前，凶恶的比他凶恶的他都不敢去呀、啊。
You can see, look at nature ourselves, where the fierce animals will always be bullying or hurting, hunting down those which are weaker and which are kinder.
我讲到这里的意思呢，就是要你去明白，启示录有很多字兽，到底是什么？大概你现在已经有答案了吧。
I'm trying to elaborate to you and describing to you the so-called beasts also from the book of Revelation and how would they be like. You'll be able to have an answer for yourself now.
他一个人的心凶恶的时候呢，他就成为野兽了。他的心已经是兽的心了，不再是人的心。
When a man's heart becomes ferocious, becomes full of hatred, it will become the heart of a beast which is no longer human.
知道吗？这时候他不是人了，他是个凶恶的野兽，他不是善良的人。
Wouldn't you agree that he is no longer a human, a kind human now, and he was now a beast?
这时候呢，他就成了他启示录说的666撒旦帮的成员，撒旦帮的一份子，那一群人，666的一群人啊。
And Jesus, at this time, he has become what is described in the book of Revelation as part of the ministry of the 666 satanic organization.
这件事情哦，我看得很清楚。
On this matter alone, I see it very clearly.
有一次我去访问一个信徒的时候，
there was one occasion when I visited a member.
他的孩子在房间玩电脑嘛，刚刚好那时电脑才出不久啦。
His child was playing with his computer, and at the time, the computer was only a new model in that era.
他妈妈只是在房间门口门外那边对他说：“不要再玩了，够了，不要再玩了。”只是这样讲而已，也没有怎样的阻挡他，只是这样说：“够了，不要再玩了。”
And all that his mother did was to talk at the door of his bedroom and say, "Oh, please stop now. It's enough." That's all that she said.
突然间，这个孩子哦，呼吸很重，呼吸很重啊，很好像野兽这样。
And suddenly, this child was breathing so heavily, like into an animal.
然后大声的哦，你不要管我，他喊出来，好像那种声音不是人的声音，很恐怖的声音，你不要管我。
Then he screamed out loud with a very fearsome and scary voice, "Don't, it's none of your business."
他妈妈吓到了，我也吓到了。
His mother was taken aback, so was I.
他妈妈说：“我只是叫你够了吗？我也没有做什么，也没有讲你什么，我只是跟你讲不要玩了，这样也不可以吗？”
The mother didn't do anything that's terrible, but all that she did was to say, "It's enough, please stop." Do you think what do you know what she, what did this child
do?
He rushed out of his room and went into the kitchen to take a knife to threaten to kill the mother.
And
I saw that it was something was going wrong, and immediately I shouted out, "In the name of Jesus, I cast out the demon." At this time, he was no longer human, he was a beast. He demonstrated no likeness of man, no kindness of man, and he was a mere animal. And just for the short sentence spoken by the mother, he was doing this. We know that it wasn't easy to cast out a demon such as this, and although the child did not attack the mother, then the child went on to hit the windows, the door with his knife. Now we wanted to conclude that he only had a bad temper. It was not so. He had an evil spirit in him. That ferocious beast in his heart had already been awakened by the devil. And there are many Bible scholars and also theologians who try to theorize and explain the concept of the satanic number 666 as something which was about technology, which was about the microchip or as well as computers. I even heard some of our own preachers of our church who explained in this way. Would you be able to accept or subscribe to this kind of theory that this 666 was only the number? Was only a number related to technology and to computers, and what? How does that have anything to do with Satan? And now we are also swiping our credit cards and also paying by PayWave. And do we now present ourselves as part of the 666?
圣经讲很清楚，启示录自己给我们当然说，这个是人呐，是人的数目，666是人来的，是人的数目，你不要把它解到什么地方去，就是人来的。The
Bible has already clearly defined this 666, the satanic number, as been related to a man, to man, to people.
有一群人啊,
There's a group of people.
已经是变成野兽，人变成野兽。
A group of people who, a group of men turned beast. Just as I mentioned about this child who went amok and who behaved like an animal, a beast and a demon.
If
And if one day we also behave in such a manner where we forsake the word of God, we lose our temper, we want to kill people, you have become the beast.
那边传道讲道理骂到你了，你觉得你没有脸了，觉得这个传道你越来越恨他，不想看到他了，你赶他下来，你不让他去到那个教会，你用你的权力，用你的开会，你对付这个传道，那你也已经变成一只兽了，在神的眼里，你是那只野兽，在杀神的仆人了。
And because you are not pleased with the sermons or a certain preacher, and you want to chase him away, you want to impose your authority against the preacher, hold meetings so that the preacher can be chased off your church, you are also becoming a beast, and you are trying to kill the worker of God with your authority.
所以我们真的要非常谨慎的，当我们的心如果不是向善，不站在神那边的时候，我们分分钟会变成野兽，成为可怕的野兽。
And therefore, we have to be always on our toes and always be vigilant, and otherwise we would turn into the beast and to be and no longer on the side with God. Why do I keep stressing on this? This was likened to Saul back then, who was already a beast.
所以圣经是用惨害、野兽般的凶恶、残酷来形容他，他就是这样。
And which is why the Bible described him as someone who wreaked havoc like unto a beast, like with the behavior of an animal.
如果你要脱离这个撒旦帮啊，这个666这个成员啊，这一群人，你要脱离，要离开他们，他们一定追上你，撒旦一定追上你，追到你死为止。
If you want to free yourself from the satanic number, the 666 or the group of organization of satanic people, and you will be exposed to the dangers of Satan and the threats from Satan until you die.
你不相信吗？你就看第九章啊。Don't
you believe that? You look at chapter 9.
这里刚刚说保罗信主嘛，十六节哈，他在十九节说他受洗嘛，是吧？十八节说他受洗嘛。
Verse 18, chapter 9, verse 18 tells us that he was baptized.
你看到23节才过几节罢了，有人就把保罗杀掉了，把扫罗杀掉了。
And just after a few verses in verse 23, that people plotted to kill Saul.
十八节才说他受洗归入主耶稣，23节才三节四节，过了三节四节，就有人要杀他，要把扫罗杀掉。
Verse 18, he was only newly baptized, but right after a few verses then, someone was plotting to kill him.
你没有想到撒旦的追杀这么快吗？很快是吗？太快了，太可怕了。
Did you expect Satan's threat and also persecution to be so fast?
因为你脱离那个撒旦帮，好像黑社会，你要脱离黑社会，黑社会能放过你吗？就是你要trying
to free yourself from a mafia group, and would the mafia group leave you alone then?
你说哎呀，我要过一个新的生活了，我要重新要做一个善良的人呢，我重新要有怎么样怎么样？你跟他讲道理，他还叫做黑社会吗？你跟他讲道理，还叫做野兽吗？
And you want to bring
out 道理的，野兽是不讲道理的。
You want to reason things out with your mafia gang, and you want to say that I want to transform my life, I want to be a new person from now. Do you think that they would accept your logic? Otherwise, they wouldn't be called the beast.
从九章二十三节开始说要杀他哦，你就一直看下去嘛。我们看圣经，看使徒行传，一直看下去，就一直要被追杀了，直到他死，很可怜。
From chapter 9, verse 23 onwards, the threats and dangers and also people trying to kill Paul started from here all the way until the end of this book.
他信耶稣归入主是付出这样的代价的，知道吗？他是这样来改变的。
For him to believe in Christ and return to Christ, and this is a price that he had to pay to transform.
但是他没有退缩的，也没有后悔的，没有。
He did not withdraw, he did not retreat, and neither did he regret. And he happily and willingly
martyr.
You try to compare this to yourself right now. Do you have people plotting to kill you just for because you believe in Christ? Do you have that?
一点伤风，一点感冒，受一点点的这种风吹，哇，我们就呱哩呱叫啊，耶稣不爱我啊，信耶稣很辛苦啊，我们就在那边吵啊，在那边闹呀。
Just because you have some mild flu or cough, and you start to complain, you start to scream and shout and cry against God.
后来保罗他自己讲，他是一个带锁链的使者，他就是除了死，自从信了主耶稣，他就是好像被锁链锁住了，是带锁链的使者呀。And
later you see that Paul was describing himself as a slave who was bound in chains, in shackles.
就是为了耶稣，他受很多苦、受很多逼迫的意思了，被锁链锁住了。He
was trying to explain that he, for the sake of believing in Christ, he was shackled to chains and he was suffering a lot.
我们来看提摩太后书第二章。We
turn to 2 Timothy chapter 2.
我们读第九节。Verse
9.
请你读二章九节。
2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 9, for which I suffer trouble as an evildoer, even to the point of chains, but the word of God is not chained.
你看到吗？我为了这个福音，受苦难，甚至被捆绑，我好像一个犯罪的人，一个罪人，一个犯人这样。
And this is for the sake of the gospel, and he suffered trouble like an evildoer.
再看以弗所书六章。
Return to Ephesians chapter 6.
我们读20节,
verse 20. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 20. Verse 20, for which I am an ambassador in chains, that in it I may speak boldly and I ought to speak.
保罗说我为了这个福音做了带锁链的使者，这个锁链锁住他，成为他的记号，成为保罗的记号，传道人的记号。
Now he described himself as an ambassador in chains, and these very chains become his mark, his symbol as a preacher.
所以最好你不要跟保罗在一起，你跟他保罗在一起，你也受苦，你也会被锁链锁住。
So you better off don't stay with Paul, otherwise you will suffer just the same way he is in chains.
老师说，要跟这么多工人、这么传道工人、这么多个，最好不要跟保罗了。你跟巴拿巴 OK 了，你跟保罗也，你跟其他的使徒都 OK 了，你最好不要跟保罗。It
would be better for you to follow Barnabas, to follow other apostles, but not Paul.
你跟他，你自己也有灾难啊，所以那些跟他的人也一同坐牢的呀。好像希拉不是跟他在一起一起坐牢啊？Otherwise，好几个工人都一样啊。
You will be exposed to the same dangers as Paul was, and you will, just like Silas and other workers who was also put into prison with him.
到后来保罗也是很可怜，他自己说，到后来的时候，没有人跟他在一起，一个都没有，都离开他。And
finally, ultimately, Paul confessed that there was no one else, not even one person was with him at the final stage of his life.
这就是保罗他的彻底的改变。This
is the complete transformation for Paul.
而且他这种改变是经得起考验，经得起很多的考验，他都经得起。His
transformation was able to withstand all kinds of tests and trials.
那从保罗的一生，从他的身上，我们用一句话来表达，来形容他，用一句话。If
we were to use a phrase to describe the life of Paul,
那就是转变了。
Is transformation.
在他的一生里面，用一句话表达，就是他的转变，他的悔改改变。Use
a word to describe the life of Paul. Is transformation. His change.
这是保罗最大的见证，改变、悔改、转变是最大的见证。That
is his greatest testimony of Paul's life to repent and transform.
也是主耶稣最大的荣耀。
It also is the greatest glory to the Lord Jesus.
也就是福音的大能，福音的能力的一个见证。It
is also the great testimony of the full power of the gospel.
所以，我们的福音啊，使人复活啊，那个瞎眼看见啊，瞎子，那个在神来讲没有什么了不起的，因为神的力量就是这么能力，神的力量就是这么伟大，那不算什么东西啊，在神来讲，那些神就不算什么的。
compared to the so-called great miracles where the blind received sight, where the dead were resurrected, in the eyes of God, these testimonies are no greater.
真正让神得荣耀的, 让神很喜悦的, 哦, 很了不起的, 感受到很荣耀的, 就是一个人的生命的改变, 这个才是真正的神迹, 再次来看, 这个是真正的神迹来的。
And what is deemed as the greatest miracle of all is not all of these, but a transformation in one's life.
也许我这样讲你不太同意。
If I say it like this, you may not agree with me.
比如说这张椅子，我现在坐的这张椅子，我本来就可以拿起来，我拿起来是很简单，因为我本来就有这个力量拿起来。那我拿起来有什么荣耀呢？我本来就可以拿，别的人也可以拿起来，没有什么好荣耀的。
As an analogy, for me to lift up this chair I'm sitting on, it is nothing miraculous because it is by my own ability that I'm able to lift it up.
那你叫一个两三岁的孩子来拿，他当然拿不起了。我觉得我们很了不起，觉得我们很荣耀。
And you ask a three-year-old child to try to lift up this chair, and this might be impressive to this child because he can't lift it.
可是我们自己知道拿起一张椅子有什么好荣耀呢？这本来就是我做得到的东西呀！行神迹使人复活，看着本来就是神做得到的东西来的，他的力量来的，有什么好荣耀呢？
But for me to be able to
lift
up the chair, and this is nothing glorious, nothing impressive, just the same as God, for God to heal the blind, to heal the sick, and also to resurrect the dead. This is nothing miraculous for him.
当然在我们来看，我们好像三岁的小孩，哇，很荣耀，哇，很厉害哦。在神来讲，这个没什么，兄弟，这个没什么。
But for us, we marveled with awe, and we behaved like a three-year-old child. But this to the eyes of God, this is nothing.
真正让神得荣耀的，真正让神心里很高兴、很喜悦的，就是看到一个生命的改变，这才是荣耀神。
What is truly pleasing and glorifying to God is a transformation in one's life. This is
truly.
The very first step for you to enter into heaven, as spoken by Jesus when he was preaching, is for you to repent.
你不能够悔改，你不承认你的罪，你不愿意悔改，天国跟你没有份。这个福音哦，怎样传都传不进去，你怎样都进不了天国。
Unless you repent and you acknowledge your sin and you acknowledge you are wrong, and otherwise you will not be able to have a part in heaven.
你不肯承认有罪，不肯悔改，不愿意改变，跟你讲三天三夜的道理，研究圣经、研究启示录都没有用的，没有用的。
If you are not willing to admit and acknowledge that you are sinful, and it is useless for me to go through 3 day, 3 night Bible study with you.
甚至你去神学院读了神学博士出来了，哇，懂得圣经很多知识了，从创世纪到启示录，对你一点用处都没有的，没有用的。Even
for you to have to go through a three-year theological course at a seminary, and it will be completely useless, of no value to you.
最多是说你有圣经的知识。
You can at most claim yourself to be someone knowledgeable.
就好像我们今天读了很多书，我们有一些知识，就这样而已。
Just as you are well educated today, you have a bit of knowledge.
但是，为什么我说没有用？因为你没有改变，你没有改变。And
why have it become useless to you? Because you have not transformed.
你不愿意悔改啊，认罪悔改。You
are not willing to repent and change.
所以怪不得主耶稣传福音，第一句话圣经记录下来，天国近了，你们要悔改，成为进天国的地步。
It is no wonder the Lord Jesus Christ said his first sentence when he was preaching the gospel that you shall repent for the kingdom of God is near.
你没有做到，你大不出去，不用讲天国了，你进不到天国的。If
you can't even complete this very first step on your journey to heaven, you shall not talk about heaven.
今天我们已经洗礼了几十年了。Now
that we have been baptized for the past many decades.
但是我提出个很重要的问题，就是你改变了吗？你说你信主几十年了，请问你改变了吗？
Let me pose to you a very critical question. Have you transformed after you have believed in Christ for the past decade? One who enter into the heaven, into the heavenly kingdom, has to be someone who has already been transformed.
好了，好像我洗礼了。
Like you have been baptized.
哦，我了，说我了。
I have been baptized.
但是我还是很骄傲的。
But I still am prideful. I'm still greedy and I still greed for the world.
然后我的心里也是不圣洁的，想入非非，常常想那些不好的事情。
And my heart is not pure, it's not clean. I'm always thinking about unholy
matters.
And I have a hideous temper. I will always swear and curse.
我已经信主几十年了。
But I have been the believer in Christ for the past decade.
请问你看我的生命所表现的几十年里面我有改变吗? 有改变吗?
Many, many decades that I have believed in Christ, have I transformed my life?
那么这种救人的生命，这个不荣耀神的生命，这个不圣洁的生命，怎么样进天国呢？ 天国怎么能够存在这种骄傲啦、嫉妒啦、恨啊、哦、咒诅啦、种种的污秽？天国怎么样？怎么能够接受这样的人进去呢？不可能吧！
How could you then earn your entry into the heavenly kingdom with your former self, who was full of hatred, curses, and swearing and unholy things? Paul was able to entitle himself to enter into the heavenly kingdom because he completely transformed his life. Allow me to testify before I conclude. This is my testimony. When I was receiving training at the theological seminary, in every prayer, I was praying for spiritual gifts. On the superficial level, you would think that the spiritual gifts are gifts to be able to minister and pastor the church well. But in fact, these are just superficial reasons for you to ask for spiritual gifts, but I have an inner reason. I knew very well that to become a preacher in Malaysia without a certain level of family history and background, you will be despised. You will be looked down upon by high position ministers and leaders of the church, not ordinary members. I'm telling you this before the sight of God, and that these people have to repent.
你又没有背景，然后又没有恩赐，你出来当传道，你会很可怜啊，会很凄凉啊。又没有背景，又没有钱，又没有恩赐，因为这样，所以我拼命的祷告求恩赐。
Because I was someone without a good family background, without great spiritual gifts and talents, I was praying very hard in the seminary for all these things. I was most attentive and I was able to focus
in.
I was praying very hard and zealously, even after the prayer sessions, I prayed at night. And I also experienced the opposition from the devil during my prayers. Until I entered into my third year at the theological seminary. My third year would be my final year before I come out as a trainee. And during one morning prayer, during the seminary, the Holy Spirit rebuked me continuously. It was as though someone was speaking to me.
你求什么恩赐？一直重复这句话。
Why are you praying for spiritual gifts? Why do you keep praying for spiritual gifts? This
你没有改变，你的生命没有改变，你没有改变，你的生命没有改变，这句话就一直重复，一直重复，你没有改变，你求什么恩赐？
And the next sentence went this way, that you have not transformed, you have not changed. Why? What kind of gifts are you praying for then?
突然间哦，好像突然间醒悟过来，整个人好像 醒过来啊，在这三年里面啊，梦叉叉，不知道自己在做什么，好像醒过来，突然就很清醒这样。
And all out of a sudden that this great realization dawned on me after this this 3 years and more, but that I was also still I was still very blurred.
我们都认为哇很爱主啊，哇很热心啊，哇很努力哦，准备道理啊，哇很努力祷告啊，哇感谢主啊，表现得非常的好。其实圣灵知道你改变了没有。你什么都没有改变，你一点都没有改变，你还是那个你呀。
In the outward appearance and outward behavior, you may be able to pray a lot and study the Bible a lot, prepare a lot of sermons, but the Holy Spirit knows best what is in your heart, whether or not you have been transformed.
我吓到了，我真的后来一直没有再祷告了，我一直在思考这个问题，一直哭，一直在思考。
I was astonished by this rebuke by the Holy Spirit, and I stopped my prayer, and I continued to reflect on this.
我想到我自己都怕。
I reflected on this with fear and trembling.
你知道我怕什么吗？
But do you know what I was fearful of?
你看我们神学院哦，早上就早祷会，然后吃完早餐就开始上课，上课，上课读圣经哦，沐浴在整个人沐浴在沉浸在圣经神的话里面，然后。傍晚又祷告整一个小时，然后晚上又祷告，天天都是祷告读圣经，祷告读圣经，这样的岁月三年了。
I've spent 3 years in a theological seminary in this way. For early in the morning after breakfast, we do a long prayer and then a full day of classes and Bible study, and we end with a long prayer as well. And we have immersed ourselves in this kind of routine for the past for that 3 years.
祷告这样的读圣经，这样每天在神的话里都没有改变，一点都没有改变。那么我想到今天的信徒。久久才来机会听一次道理，一个礼拜才听一次道理，听那个道理又不是很专心听的，又迟到的，又滑手机的，他怎样改变呢？这今天的信徒怎么办呢？我在想到这里，我害怕他们怎么办呢？
And for me to have gone through this 3 years of the theological training and seminary, I was not able to transform myself because I was rebuked by the Holy Spirit. And reflecting on our people today, our members, we are not even able to have a long time Bible study, and we are only coming to church very occasionally, and we scroll our phones and we come late for the church services. I am afraid for us because how do we transform them?
这是个很严重的问题啊，很严重的问题啊。
This becomes a very serious problem.
像我们在神学院天天祷告的，天天读圣经的，但是有改变吗？没有。圣灵说你没有改变，我自己也知道没有改变。后来检讨起来，真的没有改变，只是外表而已。
We read the Bible every day. We prayed every day in the theological seminary, but the Holy Spirit rebuked me that I did not transform.
一个生命没有改变，又这么骄傲啊！又这样的不圣洁，又这么的俗世啊，又这么虚假。然后你说圣灵要给你恩赐，你要得到神的恩赐，你要有权柄，你要有荣耀，那你那不是那什么意思呢？那这样做什么意思呢？
A life that was full of hypocrisy, full of worldly things, and also unholy pleasures. And you are expecting and you are praying for God's gifts. And if you are praying in this way, what kind of intention do you actually have?
我这样讲是有点丢脸的，但是这是真实的见证。我很感谢神，圣灵这样提示，让我醒过来。三年啊，才让我醒过来。哈利路亚。
I feel embarrassed and I feel completely ashamed of my behavior in the theological seminary. And I thank God that that the Holy Spirit rebuked me at the end of the 3 year seminary for me to awake.
所以从那个早上开始哦，我自从那个早上开始，我没有再求恩赐了，已经不求了。不是我不想要，我没有资格求了，没有资格求。
From that morning onwards, I no longer prayed for spiritual gifts. Not that I do not desire them, but I feel that I'm unworthy to ask for
them. 就是一直哦，悔改，求圣灵改变我。主耶稣，你给我力量，圣灵，你给我力量，改变我的生命，改变我的骄傲，改变我种种的不好的行为、不好的思想。主耶稣，你一定要改变我。你没有改变我，我没有见证。你没有改变我，我不能够
And then every day, every prayer, I pleaded with the Lord that he transform me, please transform me, otherwise I wouldn't be able to bear any testimony for you.
那牧养就会需要恩赐啊，所以我就跟主耶稣说：主啊，如果你觉得我需要用我的时候，需要用我了，用我的时候，那你就给我了。如果你觉得啊，我不配得到，那就照你的意思吧。我就是最后我就像主耶稣这样讲，不敢求恩赐了。And
I pleaded with the Lord Jesus that if he were to utilize me, and please grant me the gifts that I need, and other than that, I wouldn't dare to pray for any spiritual gifts as I'm unworthy.
一直到今天还是一样啊，到今天我差不多要60岁了，我还是这样，不敢求。
And until today, I'm about 60 years old, and I do not dare to ask for any spiritual gifts from God.
我见到在这三十多年的传道生涯当中，我改变了多少？是有进步，是有一些改变，但是改变了多少？ 有像保罗这样彻底的改变吗？完完全全的改变吗？有吗？ 老实说。
Then I realized that I needed to ask myself this question. After this many, nearly 30 years of my ministry as a preacher, and have I truly transformed myself just like Paul did?
所以今天读了一些圣经，研究了一些圣经，好了不起哦，好厉害哦，就要被安利了，就要做一点圣功，又是要怎么样，要在教会又成为怎样怎么样。 我看了，我心里很痛苦啊，真的很痛苦。Just
because you have studied more of the Bible and you want to be anointed as a deacon or a preacher and you are asking so much, but I feel disheartened to look at this.
最让我担忧的就是三年的认真祷告读圣经都不能改变哦，都没有改变呢。那么信徒来听一次道理，他怎样改变呢？ 我一直祷告，在祷告上思考这个问题啊。Therefore,
my greatest concern is that comparing with myself, who have not been transformed even after 3 years of long-term theological study, Bible study, and prayer, I was not able to transform. And what about the others who can't even do this? Ordinary members who don't even attend church services every day.
这个是很大的发现，圣灵的慈悲让我很大的发现，原来生命三十几年没有改变。
This rebuke of the Holy Spirit helped me to realize such an important issue that I did not transform after 30 years of believing in Christ. This is my greatest harvest or greatest lesson that the Lord God taught me. I thank God. And the rest of the, I will spend the rest of my days transforming myself.
像保罗说的，哦，我传福音给别人，人家得救了，我自己被主弃绝了。就是说，你讲这么多道理了，你读这么多圣经了，你祷告这么多个小时了，你为哦，人家进口你不能进啊，你。
Unless, lest I become what Paul said, that after I preach the gospel, I myself become disqualified and I am unable to enter into heaven.
怪不得启示录最后一章就是叫我们洗衣服了，悔改，洗衣服成为圣洁了。It
is no wonder that the last book of Revelation tells us to repent and to wash our garments to become holy.
今天讲到这里是因为看到保罗生命的改变了，那么回想我们今天改变了吗？ 改变我自己做见证，我没有什么改变哦，主耶稣赦免我。We
have discussed and studied about Paul in terms of his transformation of his life, and we examine ourselves whether we have already transformed or not.
这是圣灵讲的，圣灵责备我的，是圣灵讲的。This
was a rebuke from the Holy Spirit to me.
你求什么恩赐啊？你改变了没有？你有改变吗？你的生命有改变吗？一直这样的问，一直这样的问。
What are you praying for spiritual gifts for? Have you transformed yourself? Have you changed your life?
我要讲其他的，我要求其他的，我要赞美主都不能够，就是这几句话，一直出来，一直出，一讲话，一祷告就出来，一祷告就出来，就是这几句话。
These few verses and phrases continue to ring in my head, ring in my heart during my prayer, during this rebuke of the Holy Spirit.
所以刚才我们唱诗歌，236首是很大很稀奇的信息。我这样的人可以成为传道，可以属于耶稣，很大的奇妙，很奇妙的信息啊。
Therefore, this is a very miraculous and blessed assurance, a blessed message that even a person like me could be saved by Jesus Christ. Let us all work hard together with the help of the Holy Spirit. We sing Hymn 237.
我的生命有了真正的改变了。That
my life is finally truly transformed.
这是这首诗歌讲的。This is the content of this hymn.
什么时候改变?
When will we be transformed?
当耶稣住在我心的时候。When
Jesus comes into our heart.
237.
Sing Hymn 237.
1, 2, 3.
Now the government has partially lifted the movement control order, but it has posed some challenges to us as to who should go to church and who should remain.
有一些教会就急着要开了，有一些说又慢一点，也造成有意见不同。
There are some churches who decided to reopen, but there are also others who may want to remain closed.
我们何必这么急呢?
What is the rush for?
我们现在不是机会得好好吗?
And we are already accustomed to online services. And we are able to finally take care of the needs of everyone on online.
你忘记了传道在安息日讲的天使说 不要出这个房屋这个见证吗? 因为神的愤怒还没有过去呀, 还没有完全过去知道吗?
I have forgotten the testimony that I shared last Saturday that the angel warned not to leave your home because the fury of God has not ended.
那总会的立场也是继续在线上聚会啊, 一直到八月多是吗? 那也就是一个概念啊, 也就是一个很清楚的让我们知道。
And a GA stand is also to remain closed until further notice, and this has become our guideline for us. Therefore, let us not criticize any churches for deciding to reopen or remain closed.
求神保守我们嘛，不要因为这样大家不快乐。
Let's ask the Lord God to keep us and not to be unhappy about this.
你要考虑到，就算可以聚教会，但是还是很多人不能去的。你要考虑到这个。
You have to take into consideration that although the church is partially open, but there are some people who are not allowed to enter.
我们一起祷告，求神继续的带领看顾我们。Let's
pray together in one accord for God's guidance.
耶稣来住在我心，这耶稣来住在我心，这耶稣来住在我心，洗了草衣我心如海洋浪滚滚，这耶稣来住在我心。
感谢主，阿门。感谢主祝福带领我们晚上的聚会。
Thank God for His blessing and guidance over our evening service.
抱歉哈，迟了15分钟，实在。
I apologize for a 15-minute delay.
那么我们星期六再见啦，平安再见。
See you on Saturday. Peace be with you.
谢谢你，志成，谢谢你。
谢谢传道。